Hi, welcome you all for the spoken English course. I, Uma Naresh Reganti, is here to teach you how to speak English more confidently, effectively, and more easier way. Before going to learn this English language, let us understand what language is. Language is a tool for communication which expresses emotions, feelings, moods, ideas. It has a very important social purpose. So why English? Why should we learn English? So English is widely accepted all over the globe. More than 150 countries communicate in English. And whenever we go for any meetings or to meet with your friends or any occasions wherein you need to greet them, you wish to greet them in English. In the modern world, everything is based on the internet, and the internet is mainly in English. Everything is based on the app. App is also in English. And your daily routines like transferring your funds, your school logins, or your customer care support, all these things are in English. So it is necessary for each and every person to learn English to get your jobs. Everything and anything English is very, very important. Then, being such an important language, how to learn this English? So to start with, I'll give you some tips how to learn English. So first and foremost thing is, so English is a language, the more you speak, the faster you will learn. So the first mantra is practice, practice, practice and practice. So whenever you are learning English, get over your shyness and hesitation. As it is a foreign language, and even in your learning stages, if you make any mistakes, doesn't matter. And whenever you want to go and talk to someone, so have a practice that you stand in front of a mirror and try to speak. And in these classes, this what we do is, we teach you English through grammar. So every day you will have a small grammar lessons. Along with that, I will give you some important or some discussions, just a minute discussions, wherein you need to speak about that topic. And you cannot escape saying that I don't know about this topic. I give you such topics where I speak about yourself, introduce about yourself, speak about your family, or speak about your child, speak about the about the recipe, like this, something which comes from your heart, which you have to speak where there is no way. And practice is very, very important. And have a practice to speak to your family and friends without any hesitation. Get along in the discussions and have a practice of watching English programs. So these are the ways you can improve to, these are the ways which you can practice to improve your language. So today our lesson is on articles. So what are articles? A and the, these three are called as articles. So we all know in English there are 26 alphabets, and these 26 alphabets are divided into two parts, vowels and consonants. What are vowels? The five letters A, E, I, O, U are called as vowels. And remaining 21 letters, your B, C, D, A, F, G, H, U, V, W, X, Y, Z, all these things comes under the consonants. So what is the importance of this division? Why they have divided the alphabets into two parts, vowels and consonants? Any noun starting with a vowel like apple, egg, umbrella, it should start you should start the sentence with the word an apple, an egg, an umbrella. And remember, it should be a singular. And apart from this, any other things like ball, cat, dog, bag, all these things should start, your sentence should start with the word A. A is used before a word beginning with a consonant sound, and is used before a word beginning with a vowel sound. That's all. So you can give me some examples or you can make down, write down some examples with vowels and consonants. An apple, an orange, an egg, an umbrella, so an ice cream. So all this start with the vowel sound, and it is, remember that it should be a singular. And remaining, a ball, a cat, a bag, a pen, a pencil, all these things with a A sound. So any singular nouns with the vowel sound, we use an. Any singular noun with the consonant sound, we use a. Clear? Now let's go for the next topic, the. So when are we using this the? So we use in front of vowels as well as consonants. If it is a plural, then we use the. So take for example apples. So you call it as the apples. You can't say an apples. An apples is wrong. The apples. At the same time, the is also used when you are speaking about a particular things. So what is this particular things? Example, he tore the blue book. He tore the blue book. He tore a book. That's okay. But you are speaking about the blue book. That means already it is already the book, blue book is already introduced to you. Then he tore the blue book. I like to eat an apple. The apple is good for the health. In the first part of your sentence, you have spoken that I like to eat an apple. So the apple is already introduced to you. Now, the apple is good for the health. You are speaking about that apple which was already spoken in the first part of the sentence. So what do you understand by this? The is used for any particular things. You are identifying, already it is known to you, then you will be using the word the. Along with that, the is used for singular and plural nouns and can be used before vowels or consonants. So for you, a small homework to you all is to prepare some words with an and some words with a and some words with the. When you are speaking about the, you can say the house, the balls, the oranges, everything. So you try to concentrate on the repeated or known facts. So take for example, I bought an umbrella. The umbrella is made of plastic. So you are speaking about the umbrella which you have brought. So like that, when you are speaking about the, when you are making sentences about the, please use a long sentence and try your level best. This would be an homework for you for tomorrow. Now let us go or let us concentrate on our second part of the class, that is jam. What is this jam? It's not bread jam what you are going to eat. It is just a minute. So I told you in the beginning of the class that practice, practice and practice is a mantra to learn English more faster. So I'm going to give a topic to you all wherein till you meet me tomorrow, you are going to practice about the topic. So today our topic is self-introduction. So let me introduce myself to you all. So you all know me, but still. So I'm Uma Naresh Reganti. I'm an educationalist. So my husband's name is Naresh P. Reganti. He is a businessman and I'm blessed with a daughter and a son. So my passion is teaching. I love teaching and I reside in Bangalore. I was born in Bangalore. I'm residing in Bangalore. I love Bangalore. So Bangalore is the Silicon Valley of India. It's a hub with abundant opportunity in the field of IT, finance, marketing, medical, everything is there in Bangalore. So the climate of the Bangalore is very, very pleasant. I love Bangalore climate. And during this COVID, I thought, let me do something, like let me explore something. and let me make my time more effective, and I can help others also. I know many of you will be very, very busy, and during this COVID, I thought, why not I start this spoken English class? So I thought of starting this class to utilize my time and to share my experience and knowledge with you all. So if you have liked this class, please comment and subscribe, and also like it and encourage me so I can give you more and more classes like this. Thank you. Thank you very much.